grateful to know that God is so real. His love is a good deal, like a good meal. He's my guide and shield. Jesus Christ is alive. He died on the cross to save you and I. He lives. He lives. He arose from the grave on his third day, triumphantly. I can say he lives.
Of course, we know that he's alive and well. And because he's alive and well this morning, we can declare the victory. Yes, you're tuning into Styles FM Radio, and of course, you're listening to Victoria Miller. And of course, this is a program, Light in My World. I just want to say good morning. Good morning to all my wonderful peeps. Wherever you may be this morning, you're listening to Light in My World on Styles FM Radio.
I can feel him. I receive him. In the morning, in the evening. I can feel him. I receive him. Jesus Christ, so love the world. He died on the cross. He gave his own son. Just believe,
he lives,
and you will receive.
He arose
it is not
grave,
his will that none should perish, but all should come to repentance.
He
loves you.
He
loves you.
Light in My World with Victoria Sharp Miller. This and every Sunday morning at 6 a.m. It is a program to enlighten the understanding of Christians and non-Christians and bring people to a clearer knowledge of God.
Are you seeking a place to rent, seeking employment, or have a job vacancy? Are you selling a car or having a garage sale? Then come see us. Let Styles do the advertising for you, and you'll be on your way in no time. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Advertising Style. Advertise with Styles.
Remember Styles FM on social media. View us on YouTube, Styles FM Radio. Follow us on Instagram at Styles FM. Like us on Twitter at Styles FM 961. Become a fan on Facebook, Styles FM 96.1.
If you have been blessed by this ministry, we would like to give you the opportunity to partner with us and help us in sharing the cost to win the loss. To send your gift or offering, please call us at 583-4479 or email us at vsharpmiller@gmail.com.
Hi, this is Vonsale Belcher, and you're listening to Styles 96.1, 96.7, the People Station with Victoria Miller.
You're tuned into Light in My World.
I can't bother with this enough. I can't take it no more. Why am I facing these temptations? Lord, help me now, please.
My child, cast your cares upon me and I'll give you rest. Trust in me and I'll make you to the best. Cast your cares on me, my child, for I care for you. I'm making all your burdens all there. I make you smile, come see times.
Of course, Styles FM on the go numbers. Is that what you can use on your cell phone if you are in the USA, the United Kingdom, or Canada to reach us, to get us live on your cell phone, playing in your ears? Wherever you may go, you may be driving and you want to tune in to Styles, you can call these numbers. If you're inside of the USA, the number to do so is 213-992-4360. Of course, it's 213-992-4360. If you're inside the United Kingdom, the number to do so is 033-0010-3322. United Kingdom, 033-0010-3322. Of course, you can call or text the studio. Locally, it's 453-1444. That's 453-1444. And if you're in US and Canada, you can also call us at using this number. It's 954-338-7973. Of course, on the go, it means that you can listen to Styles on your cell phone wherever you are.
Like lust, take over my mind. He make me a fuss with this thing all the time. Why am I facing all these temptations? Jesus, help me now, please.
It's now 6:33.
My child, for I care for you. I'm making all your burdens all there. I make you smile. Come see time.
All right, Jesus. Me and yo.
Your cares on me, my child, for I care for you. I'm making all your burdens all there.
Of course, this is coming out of the voice of Emmanuel.
Well, right now, me have to take a pause.
Emmanuel, a member of the SSBG group.
Please talk, I'm listening. Cause it seems like something is missing in.
Child, you have talked from so long. But you not listen, youth, you are prolonged. Read 1 Peter 5, verse 7, what it say. Write it by your heart and not this it must stay.
Will you say, Lord, for you, me cause me cares them.
Yes.
I'm burden.
This one's a good morning, Sister V. Happy holiday, and I hope, I suppose, you full joy it to the max. And I wish you a bright and prosperous 2015. And please continue to do the good work. I love you, said Miss Brown. I know it was Miss Brown. Bless you, Miss Brown, a faithful listener of Styles FM. And I wish for you the same, sweetheart, a happy 2015. And I hope you get everything. You just receive and walk into the right pathway for 2015 that the Lord would have you. Just want to say a pleasant good morning to my husband Paul Miller and his family up there. Want to say good morning to my mother and my daughters, of course. Good morning, wherever you may be listening to me this morning. I want to say God richest blessing on your life for 2015, and I know that He has been with you through 2014. Of course, He has carried you all the way. And He will carry you over into and to the end again. I want to say good morning to Mr. Danny up there in Berrydale District, of course. To all you wonderful peeps listening to me outside of the Rio Grande Valley. You might be in Bellevue, Moortown, Barracks, wherever you may be this morning up there. I want to send a special shout out to all you wonderful peeps listening in this morning. I know you have enjoyed your Christmas, and so I want to wish you a happy new year. I want to say good morning to all Massive and Crew in Jamaica wide. Wherever you may be this morning listening to me, the Lord bless you, the Lord keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you, his countenance, and give you his peace for 2015. You might be in the United States this morning listening, or inside of Canada or the United Kingdom. I wish a wonderful and a prosperous new year for you, and God's richest blessing upon your life.
I exalt the mighty name of Jesus, the King of all kings, the conquering lion of the tribe of Judah, the one who went to Calvary and died upon the cross for my sins, the one who sitteth upon the throne at the Father's right hand.
I want to say good morning to Mr. Courtney out there in the UK, and of course, Mr. Tony as well. Blessings to you, my friends, and I wish for you a prosperous new year. I want to say good morning to Corey and Cherry, of course, have a prosperous new year. And to everybody else, we might not call your name, to all my fans, to all my partners who partner with me in this ministry. It's not a lot of people that does, but you have been a tower of strength, and I want to say to you, the Lord bless you, the Lord keep you, the Lord make his face to shine upon you and give you his peace for the coming year. Prosperous new years to you all.
I said, Lord, oh, 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 my loving Lord, I give you praise. Ooh, there's none like you, my Lord. You deserve.
Coming out of the voice of DJ Straight, of course, another member of the SSBG.
To the windows and saw the works of God. The birds that fly, the breeze that blow on me, it makes me glad. But when I did not give you praise, oh me, oh my, it makes me sad. For all the times I did not give you praise, I just want to say, hey, my loving Lord, there's none like you in this world.
Paula, good morning. Hello?
Hello?
Good morning. Hello? I'm not hearing you. I guess this is Denise, I'm not sure.
My loving Lord, there's none like you in this whole world. My loving Lord, there's none like you, none like you. My loving Lord, there's none like you in this world.
Sorry, I missed that call. You might want to try again.
There's none like you. My God's omnipotent, magnificent, all sufficient. He's never failing, he's all faithful, he's a mighty God. My God is wonderful, he's awesome and he's great. He's the powerful in him.
I want to say a pleasant good morning to Mr. Balford Watson and wife and family. I want to wish for you a prosperous new year.
Lord.
I want to wish for my church family, Kim. The Kingdom of Heaven ministry, both here in Jamaica and in Canada, a prosperous new year. I want to say to my pastors and minister, keep up the good work. You have been a tower of strength through the year. And I know that the Lord will use you to do mighty and great things for the coming new year. Caller, good morning.
Good morning, Sister Barb. That was me. I don't know what happened. Just calling to wish you a happy and a healthy new year.
Same to you, sweetheart, and I hope for you all the best.
Thank you.
All right, have a pleasant day now.
You too, and you have a blessed one. Bye-bye.
Bring me a no, you know. Yeah, yeah. Me have to say, yeah, yeah. Oh, me get over. Ooh. Must be the grace of God.
Hallelujah.
Grace of God. I've seen so many darkness in my life.
My life.
Had my share of pain and struggles and heartbreak.
Right now, Kevin is just blessing my heart.
And heartache. I've made mistakes and had to pay the price.
Price.
Oh, the grace of God was on my side, guiding me over. Through the danger, toys and fear, in the desert, wandered all alone. Wandered all alone. Nowhere, no one to turn to. Was only me and God alone. Me and God alone. That's how I got over. That's how I got over. My soul begins to wonder how I got over. How I got over. How I got over. My soul begins to wonder how I got over. Was lost and blinded by the things of this world, by riches and fame and parties and girls. Was searching and searching for what I don't know.
Of course, you know we have three wonderful segment lineup for you. If this is your first time listening to Light in My World, what we have lined up for you is praise and worship. At the moment, we are in the praise and worship segment. The next segment is taking your prayer request, which is right through the praise and worship segment.
Sister Vicky, you know, Sister Chicken Comfy Trick Way. Right now, we are sending it back to the pit of hell with Light in My World on 96.1 FM. Sister Victoria, SSBG representing.
Serve the glory.
And after which, we'll have the word. So you have praise and worship, then you send your prayer requests, and then we go into the word. Wherever you may be this morning, whatever the situation may be, you are not forgotten. You are not lost. All is not lost. There is hope in God. So call us or text us and let us touch and agree with you for the things that Christ has finished for you so you can come into your blessings. We will agree with you and touch heaven for you. You want to text us right now, the number is 453-1444. How many of us believe that the King is great and there is no one else like him? Indeed, our Father, our God, our Lord, our friend. Is beautiful. He is wonderful. There is just no one else like this King.
Can I just sing it one more time? How many know that you can think about something that the Lord has done for you that couldn't nobody do but God?
Can we really get into worship right now? Can we tell the Lord, the King of hosts, that he deserves our praise? He deserves our honor because of what he has done. Hallelujah. Nobody else, no other religion where we can look into and see love the way we see love in God. And this is not a religion. From time to time, I like to say to people, what I find is no religion. Religion is something that people just hook up on rules and tradition. What I find is a relationship, a person. Hallelujah. And so this morning, I declare it on the housetop. I declare it. I broadcast him today that he is wonderful. Well, I don't know about you, but I can declare it this morning that when I stop to think of what he has brought me through, truly, there is no one else like him. And so because he has given me the kingdom rights and kingdom privilege, I am the righteousness of God to Jesus Christ this morning. Because of that this morning, I can proudly declare that I'm the righteousness of my Father. And so here are my confessions. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. And every tongue that rises against me in judgment, I condemn. I am established in righteousness, and oppression is far from me. The weapons of my warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. I take the shield of faith this morning, and I quench every fiery dart of the enemy. I take the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, and use it against the enemy. I am redeemed from the curse of the law. I am redeemed from poverty. I am redeemed from sickness. I am redeemed from spiritual death. I overcome all because greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. I stand in these evil days, having my lion girt about with truth. And I have the breastplate of righteousness. My feet are shod with the gospel of peace. I take the shield of faith. I am covered with the helmet of salvation. And I use the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. I am delivered from the power of darkness and translated into the kingdom of God's dear Son. I tread upon the serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. And nothing shall hurt me. I do not have the spirit of fear, but power, love, and sound mind. I am blessed with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. I am healed by the stripe of Jesus. My hand is upon the neck of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup runs over. Goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. I am anointed to preach, to teach, and to heal, and cast out devils. I receive abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness. And I reign in life through Christ Jesus. I have life, and that more abundantly. I walk in the light as he is in the light. And the blood of Jesus cleansed me from all sin. I am the righteousness of God in Christ. I am the head and not the tail. I shall decree a thing, and it shall be established in my life. I have favor with God and with man. Wealth and riches are in my house, and my righteousness endures forever. I will be satisfied with long life, and God will show me salvation. I dwell in the secret place of the Most High, and I abide under the shadow of the Almighty. No evil will befall me, and no plague shall come near my dwelling. My children are taught of the Lord, and great is their peace. I am strengthened with might by the Spirit, by His Spirit in the inner man. I am rooted and grounded in love. I am blessed. I bless my natural enemies, and I overcome evil. with him. So I confess all my rights. What about you this morning? You can confess them too if you're born again, if you're a son of the King. These are your privileges. These are your kingdom rights. It is due to you. It is you who have to make up your mind to confess them daily over your life and see the transformation take place, because you have, the Bible said, you shall have what you say. What is it you're saying this morning? Are you allowing a bunch of negative words to flow out of your mouth? Come on. Your mouth is your place that you fight with. Not your fist, not with stick, not with stone. Use the word of God as your weapon. Use it through your mouth and declare all of who God says you are. Confess them daily over yourself and believe God, because he's not a man that he should lie.
Stephen is coming. Somebody worship him. If you just tuned in, this is what we're going to be doing all night.
He wants us to be holy as he is holy. Not the form of godliness, but be holy as he is holy. We were in church one Sunday, Pastor Anna, and the Lord gave me a song. And I don't get many songs like that in the middle of service. But then it just started to roll out. And I started singing, only you are holy.
This one said, good morning, Sister Vicky. I give God thanks for you and Styles. Thank you for the word that you bring to us every Sunday morning. Thank you for a wonderful year. God is faithful. Have a blessed 2015. And of course, Joy, it's so wonderful to hear from you, sweetheart. You put a smile on my face this morning because I know that the Lord is with you and that you're still there. Bless you and have a wonderful 2015 yourself. Also want to send shout out to Richie Rich in Massachusetts, Aguawama. Everybody join. Bless up yourself, sweetheart. It's so happy to have you tune in live this morning.
Only you are worthy, Jesus.
Only. I guess this is what Richie have to say. A very good morning and a happy new year to you, Sister V. And the Styles FM crew, keep up the good work. Of course, that is what Richie have to say to us this morning. And so, Richie, God bless you. Make his face to shine upon you and give you his peace.
Faithful,
Say good morning to the SSBG group. Wish for you a prosperous new year.
Have been blessed by this ministry, we would like to give you the opportunity to partner with us and help us in sharing the cost to win the loss. To send your gift or offering, please call us at 583-4479 or email us at vsharpmiller@gmail.com.
You can't afford to miss it. The Road to Glory, your Sunday morning gospel and inspirational music program on Styles 96.1 from 9 a.m. until 12 noon. Tune in. Styles, the People's Station.
Hi, this is Vonsell Belcher, and you're listening to Styles 96.1, 96.7, the People's Station with Victoria Miller.
This is Light in My World.
Sister V, you are God woman. Now go be a bad woman. You depend on the right station, Styles FM 96.1, with a positive vibration.
In your prayer. The time now is 7:01 a.m.
That's where I belong. In your Oh Lord, my God, in your presence, that's where I'm made strong, seeking your face.
And I want to go where the rivers cannot overflow me, where my feet are on the rock. Yes. And I just want to hide where the blazing fire cannot burn me, in the cleft of the rock.
Who is this rock? Is Jesus. Hallelujah. We talk about the presence some Sunday morning ago, and what we said, when the presence of God is manifesting, no dead thing, no negative things can stay negative. No dead thing can stay dead, because the presence brings life to our life. Hallelujah. And so, even where David is concerned, David was so upset when he had to leave the ark at Obed-Edom house. But when David understands just how the presence of God in the covenant of the ark had blessed Obed-Edom house, David went back for the ark, because he understands that it is the ark that holds the presence of the Almighty God. It is the ark with him. He was carrying the presence, and so he could not afford to let this presence stay away from him. And so David did all that he could to bring back the ark into his position. And when the Bible said when the ark came back into David's position, the Bible said he danced mightily before the ark of the Lord, because he was just so elated that the presence of God was now with him once more. There are times when you're going through your situation. There are times when you're going through your struggle. There are times when you're going through all different things. It means then that the presence of God is not manifesting. We are now the ark of that covenant where the presence live. But in order for it to manifest, it has to come upon us. That upon anointing has to be there. And if that upon anointing is there, then we will see wonderful things. Because the Bible also says that in the presence of the Lord, there is fullness of joy. Now when the presence is drawn in, when the presence is not upon, it means that we are going through some form of testing. It means that we are going through some stuff to develop us at times. Or maybe it's just that you don't care about the presence. And so you are comfortable just sitting down there with that presence on the inside and having all kind of mess around you. But when I go to the valley, when I go to the valley of the shadow of death, I crave the presence of Almighty God. But one thing I know about the presence that I carry, that it will not allow me to be destroyed. Even if it is not manifesting, it will not allow me to be destroyed. And so let us go there.
It's the place of a
presence is important. The manifested presence is what I'm talking about. And so I heal myself to the presence of Almighty God. I want him to manifest. I want him to come and dwell
in your presence.
Because these are the things that happen when the presence of God is upon us.
In your presence.
Play that back for me one more time.
In your presence, all my fear is gone. In your presence is the blaze of a lamp.
How much do we crave for this presence?
All fear is gone in your presence. In your presence. It's where I belong. In your presence. In your presence.
See that upon anointing, it is for service. And every time I sit in Styles FM, there is an upon anointing for me to do the will of my Father.
In your presence.
As a matter of fact, anywhere me go and take up one microphone, the presence is upon me. Jesus said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. It is upon us to do the will of the Father. You see, without the presence, without the anointing, there's nothing that we can do to change lives. And so we are to value this presence. We are to seek for it. We are to know about it. Because it is the presence of God, the anointing that breaks you. Seek to be in that presence this morning.
And everything will be okay.
Clear that back for me one more time.
In your presence. All my fear is gone. In your presence. Is the blaze ever long? In your presence, all fear is gone. In your presence, yeah. In your presence.
Can we announce it this morning? It is the presence of Almighty God in our life that makes us different from anybody else. It is because of who we house this morning and who we are on the inside that makes us different from the world. The Word of God said, greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world.
I need to hear from you.
That in me need to be upon me. I will see great and mighty things manifesting before our eyes. You see the chaos that surrounds our world, the situation and the circumstances. It is the presence of Almighty God that can break these yokes and set people free. Can we crave to be there? Can we crave that upon anointing this morning and know who we are and what we are about?
Tell me that you'll never leave, and everything will be okay. In your presence, all fear is gone. In your presence, there's healing. In your presence.
what it feels like to be like Moses, to make the statement that if your presence doesn't go with us, we don't want to go. We confess our absolute need for you.
You see, we know what it feels like to be like Moses. When we see all the dead situation around us, we know that the presence of God is not being manifest.
Lord, we want to see your face.
And so we want to pray like Ezekiah this morning.
We want to experience you.
William McDowell.
In a new place. We're not satisfied with where we've been. There's a holy dissatisfaction in the midst of your people. We don't want what we've had before because we know that there's more. We know there's more. Some of you have been in the place where you've been asking, is this all there is? I know there's got to be more. I want you to know tonight that there is more. You have not peaked in your relationship with God, but every day with him is sweeter than the day before. There's more. There's more. Don't stop, because there's more. There's more.
Was this person.
Went down into the deepest valley, looked all around down there, couldn't find nobody. I went across the deep blue sea, couldn't find one to compare to your grace, your love, your mercy. Nobody greater
than you. Oh.
Yeah, what am I doing now? Couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low.
They say.
Still couldn't find nobody.
Balfour, big up yourself.
Nobody greater. Nobody greater, no. Nobody greater than you.
You talk about love, I'm heavy.
Searched all over, couldn't find nobody.
He will never leave you nor forsake you.
High and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody greater. Nobody greater. Nobody greater than you.
When you talk about forgiveness, him know how to do it.
Nobody can heal
like you can.
Oh, most holy one, you are the great I am. Awesome in all your ways, and mighty is your hand. You are he who carried out.
Yes, see, if you have search, quit that. Here it is.
Couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low. Still couldn't find nobody.
Your
nobody
wife.
Nobody great.
Nobody greater. Jesus.
Nobody greater than you.
Couldn't find nobody. It's a whole heap of people I search. Some of them the pan world so long. And they still a look for smaddy. But here we are.
Body great. Nobody's greater than you.
Come on, lift those hands for real in here. Come on.
Nobody greater. Nobody greater, Jesus.
Nobody greater than you.
Nobody greater.
Nobody's great.
Nobody greater. No.
Nobody's greater than you.
Now lift those hands, singers, and let's just give him the glory. Nobody greater.
Nobody's greater.
Couldn't find nobody.
Nobody greater.
Nobody greater than you.
Nobody greater than you.
I dare you lift your hand and say that with us tonight. Come on. Nobody greater.
Nobody.
Now them song you play for gone for. You see, everybody when we said they never would have make it without Jesus Christ in a 2014 and yeah, go over in a 2015. Let me hear you sing that one. Yeah.
When I look back over all you brought me through, I can see that you are the one I held on to. And I never would have made it.
Yes, when I think about the pit in the school fee. There is something there now. You did a wonder how September did a go. But here it is, you are in December. What me say? So guess what? You see him God will keep you and make things come true for you. In a 2014, guess what? He's going to do abundantly. Above that which you can even think this morning or imagine for 2015. Can you see it with me? If you know, so you're stronger and wiser because you go through enough things. Let me hear you sing that one. Yeah.
Yeah.
Somebody just need to testify to somebody next to him. Tell him, I'm stronger. I'm wiser. I'm better. Much better. When I look back over what he brought me through, I realize I made it because I had you to hold on to. Now I'm stronger. Now I'm wiser.
Indeed, we are stronger. We can all say and testify to the arm of the Lord in our lives. And so right now, me just want to big up the entire peeps up there in Massachusetts. The man Marlon, my brother-in-law, and Romy, of course. They are with my husband at the moment. And I know that you guys have been enjoying the program. I just want to say to you, say, keep it locked now. Introduce somebody else to Styles FM Radio, because you don't know that station is large to take over Jamaica and the world. You don't know this a light in my world, sell it off for me. I'm in love with no more. I just want to big up all my peeps, Massive and crew, wherever you may be this morning listening to me. This is the program Light in My World. And of course, you are locked to Styles FM Radio, and this is Light in My World.
To encourage myself.
Victoria Miller, of course, is the person.
I'm stronger. I'm wise. I am better. So much better. When I
Daddy Miller, keep yourself warm.
Hold on to, but I never would have made it. I never could have made it without you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Lord. Oh, good God Almighty.
You see, because he allow us to make it in spite of what we saw. Hear what we have to tell him, say again this morning.
I've had my share of ups and downs. Times when there was no one around. God came and spoke these words to me. Praise will confuse the enemy.
Life and mercy of ups and downs. Times when there was no one around.
God came and spoke
these words to me.
Praise
will confuse the enemy.
So I started singing. Problems.
If you have been blessed by this ministry, we would like to give you the opportunity to partner with us and help us in sharing the cost to win the loss. To send your gift or offering, please call us at 583 4479 or email us at vsharpmiller@gmail.com.
Relive the music memories. Solid Gold Style Sundays from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. with your host, Captain Baker, on your favorite station, the Paper Station, Styles FM 96.1. Reminisce on the past with the music. Flashback on what it is that was. It's a program you don't want to miss on a Sunday. Solid Gold Style from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. You join me. Let us recap the music of yesteryear. Cool.
Live the best music experience.
Sunday peppering on Stars FM 96.1. Sundays 8 to 12 midnight. To begin the work week only on Stars FM.
Need a lifestyle change? Tired of the same old, same old? Sister Peace Restaurant in Hope Bay is a healthy alternative. Vegetarian dishes, natural juices, puddings, shakes, and much more. Open Monday to Saturday, 11 a.m. to 6 p.m. Look out for the pretty, pretty building just outside of Hope Bay. Telephone number 532-0723.
Mr. Brown, Mr. Brown, the work material done, you know. What me fi do?
Check Robinson's and Sons Hardware, man. Them have everything you need and more. They are at 18 West Palm Avenue, Port Antonio, Portland. Paints, nails, doors, everything to meet your hardware needs and much more. Call them at 993-9763 or 382-6209 and email them at sandrhardware@gmail.com.
Mr. Brown, we get everything we need quick and fast. Sure, maybe we could have just stopped the chatting so we could have done the work just as fast.
What was that, Johnny?
No, man. But just as say Robinson and Sons are going good.
Robinson's and Sons Hardware. We are always here to serve you.
Planning a party, club night out, stage show, a gospel concert, or even a business sales event? Let Styles FM be a part of your promoting tool. Take advantage of our low-priced promotion packages with commercials, interviews, giveaways, reviews, and much more. We have special offers when you mix and match and bundle your options. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Styles FM, for the most effective way to exploit your marketing dollar.
Hi, this is Vonsell Belcher, and you're listening to Styles 96.1, 96.7, the People Station with Victoria Miller.
You're tuned into Light in My World.
The time is now 7:34 a.m.
Of ups and downs, times when there was no one around. God came and spoke these words to me. Praise will confuse the enemy.
Life and mercy share of ups and downs. Times when there was no one around.
God came and spoke
these words to me.
Sometimes when you go to your hard time, people have a lot to say. Now you can't catch the gaze and the stare and the look pan, and you hear what them a say deep down in your spirit. You feel what them a say, and you know what them a say. But all when them a say what them a say, you can't keep a smile on, because you know say God a go come true for you in spite of what is happening, in spite of what you can't see right now. Just know who you are and know who God is to you. Yes, they are talking. Because you are down now, but just know this, that God is going to use your down situation to glorify himself. Keep a smile. Smile with them same way all when them laugh.
So I started singing.
I started laughing.
People were laughing.
Because
they knew my problems.
Can you see when them a stare and a say all kind of something about you? God is going to use your life as a testimony before their eyes. You need to understand, you know, that if you never have a situation, God is not able to glorify himself in your life. So every channel coming to your life is an opportunity to glorify God. Every challenge you're up against is an opportunity to glorify God. Don't watch the steer. Do not let these things alarm you and make you feel discouraged this morning. But use them knowing that in spite of what they must say, they have been saying so much for a long time. But yet still your God will be strong for you. And he's going to bring you out with a mighty hand. Okay, I'm praising him in advance this morning like you know it. You see, when you praise him, when you begin to open your mouth and give him thanks, you're saying, Daddy, I know that you love me. And I know that you have all things available for my life and for godliness in me. And so I'm praising you because I believe you and all that you said about me.
Praise. In the good times.
Praise.
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 When things are going wrong.
Praise.
Praise him.
Praise.
Help me in here.
Praise.
Come on and praise.
Can we praise him in advance this morning? You see, you're praising him in advance that it is your positive action to say, yes, Lord, I believe you. It is your positive response. It is your faith. Your faith become your positive response of praise.
Come on, everybody, let's give God this worship. If you know he's awesome, come on, stand on your feet, everybody. If you know he's awesome, you're in awe of his grace, you're in awe of his goodness, you're in awe of his mercy, you're in awe of his provision. He's great and he's greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. Come on, everybody, lift your hands as we lift our voices. Come on, say, my God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
Come on, say, he can move mountains.
He can move mountains.
Keep me in the valley.
Keep me in the valley.
Come on, say it. Hide me from the rain.
Hide me from the rain.
That's it.
Do we believe that this morning?
My God is awesome.
Come on. Heals me when I'm broken.
Heals me when I'm broken.
Strength where I've been weakened. Forever he'll reign. My
Come
God
on.
Is awesome.
My God is awesome.
How many of us know that God is so awesome?
Keep me in the valley.
Keep me in the valley.
Hide me from the rain. Has he ever covered you? Come on. My God is awesome.
How many of us know that we can be in the rain and God still hide me?
He'll see when I'm broke.
How many of us know that we could be under the water and God keep us?
Forever he'll reign.
How many of us know that we could be going to the fire and not burn? How many of us know that we could be cast down but not utterly destroyed?
He's awesome. Come on. My God. Verse 2. Savior of the whole world.
Savior of the whole.
Giver of salvation. By his stripes.
You see when people say you're done?
Yeah, my God is.
And say so you can't come back.
Listen.
You just need to understand. So all you need is Jesus. His, because I don't see them talk at the last star. It's what he says about you. And what he says about you is that he wish above all that you prosper and have a good life. So when you put your hand in his hand, he's going to take you to that place of stability. I'm telling you, by yourself, you can't make it. If you're outside of God and Christ this morning, you need to run into him. Because you need somebody. You need a friend. You need a savior. You need a divine one, a spiritual one. Because trust me, the flesh by itself can't do nothing. It is weak. But when you have Jesus, when you have him in your life, or when you go through the fire, he promised you that he will go through the fire with you. And because he's with you, he will protect you from the flames.
He's been good, you said. He's holy. He's holy. He's holy.
He will protect you. If you have to go through, yes, you will go through, but you are just going through. You are not staying there. You will not be devoured by these flames.
Come on, everybody, let's get...
This one is going out to Mr. Danny.
If you know he's awesome, come on, stand on your feet, everybody. If you know he's awesome, you're in awe of his grace. You're in awe of his goodness. You're in awe of his mercy.
Yes, when you know that God is with you, you have privileges.
He's great and he's...
You have benefits. Praise. You have rights. You are not your own. So nobody can destroy you. They might farm their weapon against you, but it will not prosper. It will not bring out what they farm it to do. It might look like it affect your life, but it cannot destroy you.
Come on, say he can move mountains.
Because there's a coming back. Hallelujah. Job said, on my appointed time, I'm going to wait until my change comes. I don't know who I'm talking to this morning. But if you're outside of God this morning, I want to say to you, hope is in God. You don't have to stay where you are and feel like there's nothing that you can do. You don't have to die where you are and think that there's no place for you. I'm saying to somebody this morning that there is hope in God. Your life can be changed. It can be turned around.
Come on. My God is awesome. Heals me when I'm broke. Strength where I've been weakened. Forever he'll reign. One word. Come on, everybody.
Can you tell him this morning?
All together.
And we give every praise to our God this morning. Can we too ask the Lord to be magnified? You see, when he is magnified, he's made larger. He becomes bigger. He becomes brighter. Can we ask him to be magnified this morning? So we can see him, so we can experience him.
And there is nothing
many times we only believe what we can sense. Love. Wisdom of man.
Forgive me.
It's time you realize that there is a God.
And I have responded to that. Instead of your light and your mercy.
And we respond only to what we can see, hear and feel. And we refuse the word of God coming over to us so many times. But here is Jason Mighty. Say, God, if I have received only the wisdom of man, forgive me.
And in my eyes and with my soul, oh Lord, be magnified.
How many of us want this morning for God to be magnifying our eyesight? How many of us want this morning for God to be seen for who he is in our sight? Would you rather that God be magnified before you? Or all that you're after is fame, riches, and money? If that's what you're after, then you're a fool. Because when God is magnified, all these things can be added to your life. They become the base things around you. Can you ask the Lord this morning to be magnified? Highly exalted, and there is nothing you can do.
You can do, Lord. My Lord, my eyes are on you. Be magnified.
Just want to say a big up to ULN family. Mr. Styles.
Sister V, preach your word, the gospel. It are the good news, and a religion, and a tradition. Preach your word, and a legalism. This are no ism, schism, a Christ something. Sister V, preach your undiluted word.
Of course, it's time for the word. As you hear, Mr. Mighty tells us to be magnified, telling us to magnify the Lord. Ask the Lord to be magnified this morning. Because it's only when you are hungry to see him. It's only when you want to see him that you will see him. He's not going to just come into your life if you don't want him. He's not a God who imposes himself on others like that. You see, nobody don't want to be somewhere where they don't want them. And so it is the same with our God. When you search for him, when you want him and you search for him, you will find him. It is your request. It is your desire. And so this morning, here is the word of God coming over to you live from Styles FM studio. The program is Light in My World. And of course, the minister is Victoria Miller. The time is now 8:00. The message to you this morning, the topic of the message is exalt Jesus and not your efforts. Exalt Jesus and not your efforts. You see, Romans 1 is showing you about the Apostle Paul. And what Romans 1 shows you with the Apostle Paul entering into Rome, preaching this gospel. And he showed the people there that no man is without guilt before God. He showed the people there that whether you were Jews or Gentiles, whatever nation you were, the works that you are doing, anything that you do to make yourself righteous of your own self, God does not see you as a righteous man. And so Paul preached this gospel of salvation in Rome. In Romans 2, he began to show them how faith has come. And because they realized that it was now by faith, there was no place for boasting about how much rules was kept, because they now realize the covenant of grace. So right there we see that neither Jews nor Gentile was righteous before God. In order for a fallen man who is imperfect to appear righteous before God, he had to be able to keep all the laws of Moses. An imperfect man to keep a perfect law. How is that possible? You hear me say, in order for an imperfect man to be seen as righteous, he had to keep all the law of Moses. And you hear it, say, no care how you keep one and you feel one, you're guilty at all. So this was a no-no. The law could not save man because man could not keep all the laws of God. Now, Paul showed the people all of this. In some religion, we have seen this practice of the law continually in our days today. I've seen it where we have looked into the Rastafarian religion. And in some aspect, they are trying to keep the laws. Which we know that if man could have kept the law perfectly, then there wouldn't be any need for Jesus coming into the earth, because man could have made himself perfect. But because man could not make themselves perfect, here is God in his loving kindness who sent someone who was perfect to keep a perfect law. And so I begin to study out the different religion. And one religion that I looked at was the Rastafarian. And where they adapt certain things about the law of Moses. Right? I've seen where they tell their woman they can't come near them in times of menstruation because she's unclean, as if the male man in himself was clean. You see, under the law, even if you have a common cold, you would be unclean. And we see so much discrimination against the female man in this regime. We see the discrimination, and most of the time, the man have fall too. But they were not discriminated against. I've studied the Muslim, and I've looked into these religions, and I've looked on their traditions and their practices, and they have these laws that govern their foundations, and they stick to them. But in all of them, what I found that was common among these religions is that woman is being discriminated. Why? But here is Jesus, the darling Son of God. I've seen where woman have even been brainwashed to think that, yes, it is good that they give service to these men and lord them up. And worship them. Because what I see in these religion and how these women have to work and these men live like king. But you know, in the beginning, that's not what the intent of the Father was, you know. That wasn't the intent. Because the Bible told us that he gave them both dominion and he blessed them both and give them dominion. He give them rulership in the earth. And being a woman in this earth, it does not mean that your dominion is taken away. It shouldn't be so. But because sin entered the world, then the Bible say to the woman, your desire shall be unto your husband. And so we see that there has been a discrimination against female and against woman constantly. But I want to say to you this morning, whether you are male man or female man, know this. If you are in Christ, then your desire is no longer to your husband. Your desire is unto God. And that makes you free. That makes you rule. That makes you reign beside your husband if you are married. It makes, because you are given dominion, not to be under his feet, but alongside this man. Right? To be equal to become one with. And so many religion, even in the Christian religion today, as they call it, we see that the man is being lording over the female. Controversy right there. And we see it, and it is presenting an act of slavery. And what we see there, and they still quote the scripture from Genesis that the man is the leader. The man is the leader, yes. The man is in command, but the woman is there to bring the man into destiny as the helpmeet for the man. And so we don't lord over people. We, once you are born again, know this. You have been liberated from where the curse was, where your desire was unto the man. You are now supposed to rule by his side together. The Bible said the two flesh become one. You're one with your partner. So you don't put the woman under your feet. You don't do that and rule and lord over her, but you rule together. Hallelujah. And so we are so glad this morning that Jesus Christ, when he came into earth, he did not bring a racial issue. He did not bring a gender issue. He did not bring anything of such cause. But what Jesus brought to earth was liberation to all men, both the male man and the female man. And when I talk about man, I'm not just talking about the white man. Because if you interject this teaching to some people, then we tell us a white man write the Bible and a white man philosophy and all the hypocrisy. White man mess up the word of God way over there in history. And that's all the doing of the enemy. The enslavement that the black people were under, and they give people the Bible to you, that was... The word of God was not being preached there. It was slavery. And so we want to take a closer look and don't mistake the word of God, because that was all the doing of the enemy, just the same. Christ came to earth to liberate all mankind. Every man is equal in the sight of the Almighty God. There's no racial issue with God. And so we need to understand this fully and grasp it, that it wasn't God who tell the white man to preach a different doctrine, to preach religion and bondage and slavery. It wasn't God. It was all the devil's work. And they paint a picture to make you look like God. But is that the truth? Today, if you listen to the truth, it will make you free. Free from religion, free from mental slavery, free from religious bondage. Hallelujah. God does not want us to be in a religion, but he wants to have a relationship with mankind. And so that's what I'm about today, to enlighten the mask, to show people into the heart of God, to let people understand who God really is and what he's all about. He loved mankind. And because of his love, he sent Jesus Christ into the world. Right? He sent for Jesus into the world so that we can have the privilege to glory in who God created us to be. We can all see each other as one blood. Christ didn't brought a racial issue to earth. It is the enemy who used the white man in history to present a wrong doctrine. Any doctrine that talks about race, color, and gender is segregation. And in segregation, there is always going to be division. And in division, there is war. So you will never have peace. And Christ wasn't about war. It was about uniting the human race. So he did not bring a racial issue, but he bring peace. The songwriter said the Christmas carol, hark now, hear the angels sing. Glory to the newborn king, peace on earth. He bring peace to mankind. He brings liberation. He bring oneness. He brings solidarity to man. But with the doctrine that you have heard, the practices of these people over the years, that was just a pitched up pain to look like. That wasn't the truth. Here is the truth of God, and it is coming from the same Bible. But you need to look into it afresh, because there are some things that was misinterpreted, wrongly put. And the Bible said we need to divide the word of God accurately. Hallelujah. So we can get the right understanding and get the right belief. It is out of the right belief that we will, the right belief will bring right thinking. And when we think right, we will do right things. So, you know, just come about in just practicing a bunch of things, and things become practical. It becomes a duty. It becomes obligation. God don't want you to serve him out of obligation. He wants us to serve him out of love. You know how hard it is to serve out of obligation? It's easier to serve somebody when you love them. It's easier to give up your life because you love. You will never want to give up your life because of obligation. And so we can be truly committed to God when we understand who God is and what he has done for us. But we don't know him. We hear about him, but how much do we know him? And so I said, any doctrine that talks about race, color, and gender is segregation. Jesus come back to reach all man, not a race, was excluded. And what goes for one in his sight goes for all. That is why he say, go to all the world with the gospel. He said, go to all the world, teaching them to observe, bringing to them the gospel of the kingdom. Because many have come before and they mess you up. Many have come before and preach religion. Many have come before and teach man-made philosophy. Many have come and paint a picture. And it wasn't me. So here is Christ saying, come on, talking to his disciples. He said, go in a every man world. You know why in a every man world? Concept. Knowledge. Setups, these mindsets are there, and they don't know the truth of who God is. But like the devil bring a concept to Eve in the garden, and Eve believe. So it is this morning that I'm bringing the gospel to you this morning. If you can be liberated this morning, if you believe what I'm saying to you. It is in your belief system that you can be made free. So you have all kind of information in your mind already. And somehow we don't know nothing. Nothing in there about God. But this morning I bring to you the gospel of the kingdom. And so I want you to, if you look at Romans 4, there is two illustrations with David and Abraham. What I have to say to you this morning, your spirit man that is born again, if you're a born again person, your spirit man will welcome it and receive it, because the spirit that is born again inside of you know the truth. But it is your mind. It is your mind that is mixed up. Your mind have the controversy inside of it, the confusion. And all of that is in the mind. So maybe you're not able to receive it as quick as you don't want to receive it because of what is already in the mind. But your spirit man receive it this morning, because your spirit man know the word of God. And even as Jesus said, my sheep know my voice. This morning I want you to be open. Be open to receive God's words. Do not allow the things that you have heard over the years by religious teaching to let you not receive the truth of God this morning. I am not coming to you from a particular book. I'm coming to you from the Bible, the King James version of the Bible also. And so I want you to be willing to be open up yourself. Not because you hear something already and you say, well, I saw that preacher that teach me and I saw that man there. Listen and try to rationalize. Try to see if there is any truth in what I'm saying where the word of God is concerned. So it might go against your mind. But prepare to open up yourself to renew your mind so that you can be changed. It is the renewal of your mind. Now, when you renew your mind with the word of God, you will think different and you will see new things coming out of your life. If your mind not change, you can't change your behavior. Know that this morning. Romans 3 and verse. So we are going to be looking at Romans 4, verse 1 to 5. Hallelujah. And Romans 4 and verse 1 to 5, read. It said, what shall we say then? That Abraham, our father, has pertaining to the flesh, had found. For if Abraham was justified by works, he had whereof to glory, but not before God. For what say the scriptures? Abraham believed God, and it was counted unto him for righteousness. Now to him that worketh is the reward not reckoned of grace, but of debt. Verse 5. But to him that worketh not, but believe on him that justified the ungodly, his faith is counted for righteousness. As I said before, exalt Jesus and not your efforts. Now we look into that and we can proudly look at Romans 3 and verse 27 and ask the question like where Romans 3 and 27 asks. So where is boasting now? If it is not our works that qualify us to be in the righteous status where God sees us as righteous, what is it man have to boast about? Where is boasting? Because it's no work of man that makes man right with God. It's the work of Jesus Christ. It's what Jesus Christ did for mankind that makes them right. But when you look at what mankind is still doing in the religious section, the practices and all of these things and the rituals and these things that they carry on and behave as if they have to do all of them something because of this and then service and this are going to make them right with God. And then the one heap of something for one listen and tell us if you don't do them, you're not going to give. But is that the truth? Because if these things can make you go to heaven, then it tells me then that I want me do, I feel me work, I feel me effort, save me. But that's not what the word of God says about it. The word of God says that it is not any works of man. It was Abraham's work that justified Abraham. In fact, when God called Abraham, Abraham was just like any other man. He have issue, he have problem, he have situation, he have all kind of things when I go right in my life. But here God call him and begin to talk to him. And the Bible says Abraham believed God. And because he believed God, this belief when he believed God, it was now counted unto him for righteousness. It was counted unto him for righteousness. It was no work of the flesh that Abraham was made righteous. It was not what he eat or where or which deity he worship that makes him right before God. It was because he believed God. Abraham believed God and it was counted unto him for righteousness. So these are some stuff a lot of us can't angle right now. But nevertheless, I'm going to say them this morning because it is the truth. And the Bible said the truth will make you free. Free from what? Bondage. A lot of the belief, a lot of the religious stuff we practice today, they are just bondage. They are just yoke to keep us in control. To keep control, people control your life. People tell you what to do, how to do, what to do. And you do them because you believe so there's something that's going to make you righteous. The devil is a liar. It is the blood of Jesus Christ that qualifies you and I. His blood makes a difference in our life. You see, the day of atonement, over back in the days of the Old Testament, you know, the people did not write a long list of apology to come to the day of atonement to tell God how they sorry for their sin. They did not come to God bawling and say, God, me not going to do it again. The people know that without a sacrifice, without an animal being sacrificed, their forgiveness was futile. And so when they come with their animal sacrifice, Why do you say that, Minister Sharp, this morning? What I say that to say this. It is Jesus who qualify us. Without you adhering to the blood of Jesus this morning and his finished work, you cannot be seen as righteous. Not care how you ball and beg and plea and fast and pray and read your Bible and do all of the things them with up on the church list. Until you receive what the Lord Jesus Christ did for you on the cross of Calvary. It is his blood. God not take none of your works. Because look here, he said, this is my beloved son in whom I'm well pleased. It means then that the only sacrifice that pleased God for sin, it was Christ's blood upon Calvary. So why we are beggar? Why we are load? Why we are yoked down people with works? And I tell them all kind of hypocrisy. Look here, I mean, I say people could just relax in a salvation and not do nothing, you know. That's not what I'm saying, you know. But you need to get an understanding of the work that you're doing and why you're doing the work that you're doing. Because your works is not to save you. Your works can't save you this morning. So you need to exalt Jesus Christ and the work that he did for you and believe what he did for you. And the Bible said it's only then you shall be saved. The Bible also told us about the Jews, the Pharisee who smote his chest at the altar and say, Lord, I thank you that I pay my tithes and I do my vows. And he begin to tell God about all I work when do as a Jew. And the Bible said, here was this publican who came at the altar and smote and bowed his head and said, Father, I'm a sinner. But I need your mercy. God is waiting for some people like that, you know. God is waiting for some people to be totally stranded out of what they can do and begin to depend on God for what they need. That is why the human race is so messed up. Because over the year, we have graft an understanding that we need to work for what we want. And like every other religion, we work and make sacrifice to them God. That's so we treat God too. And not understand that God himself makes sacrifice for we. Accept him sacrifice, man. Receive if you want to do, man. Because anytime you receive, you always say your work that don't mean nothing. Why you continue to work then? Why you continue to yoke and to teach people that is what them do and which day they worship and the clothes that they wear and the food that they eat and all of these things? Why is these things being exalted more than what Jesus Christ do? It is being exalted. This morning I come to say to you, exalt Jesus and not your efforts. I want you to see that Abraham believed God. Right? Romans 3 said, where is boasting now? Boasting is located where there is works. And anytime you believe, say, your works make you righteous before God, then that's why you're not supposed to put on other people and tell other people, say, then this and then that. And then this and then that. Because you think, say, now, how you do. But the word of God is saying to us this morning, no works of man can save man. You have to put your trust and your belief in the righteousness of Jesus Christ for your salvation. If you are saved and always find yourself boasting about what you do, then there is more emphasis placed on you than on Christ. You have some people who say, boy, me have the Holy Spirit in me. Can't me live my life clean. And that's why me feel. If you're in a wrongdoing and you make no mistake, you're not going to get him. And then tell you all kind of hypocrisy. And then tell you something. And then tell you say you know if you do this. And you know if you sleep with your husband if you're going to come lead choir. And you know if you do... What kind of hypocrisy? And these are the things that the church magnify. I'm telling you, I've been in religion. I've grown up in religion, and it get to me head in such a way that it's like more than one year church people. But when I understand that this was just a wrong doctrine, it was misinterpreted, I began to search for the king for myself. Because too many of us, we are looking on Moses' experience of God. We are looking on David's experience of God. And all the different Bible patriarchs. We are looking on their experience and talking about where God, how God good. It's going good to them. But what is your experience of God this morning? Have you begun a search? Have you come to a place where you say, God, I can't do this? From a baptized till now. Me in a some situation when I change. Me in a some kind of lifestyle where me can't do better. This is it. I can't just be God church and come on my yard and God church and come on my yard and God work and that's it. It cannot be. How much are we hungry for God? How much we get to a place? Because that's when I was locked up in religion, I was in bondage. And I cried out. I said, God, I need to see you. If you are real like Moses, I said, show me your face. And of course, God is a spirit. You're not going to look up our physical face. But you want to experience him for yourself. You want to be able to tell somebody that my life was way down here. I was in the gutter. I was in the rubble. I was in the muck. But when God reached down his hands for me, things begin to turn. Things begin to pull apart. Things begin to set together. Come on. You need an experience this morning. It's time you stop living off of other people's experience and when they say about God and begin to have your own say. And so as I said before, we are locked up in religion, locked away in bondage, locked away in rules, locked away in rituals, locked away in regulation, and we exalt these things above the finished work of Jesus Christ. But it has shaken now. We not see it. It gets sour because we realize that all I want to do, the church is shaking. It's about to tear down and mash up because you're stuck on religion. And God is waiting for a group of people when are religious, when are live off of rules and practices. God is waiting for some real people to manifest in glory in the earth and show people, say, I'm me a God. Come on. How much of us are ready for that? We have been through the stages where we just keep rules. Like we under the law, same way. And we work for what we want. Anytime we want something to do, we go fast and we go pray and we do all kind of intercessory. And say, I dem ya something that we have to go do. And if we not do then something, we can't get nothing. God for do nothing for we. Look here, what the Holy Spirit is saying to you this morning, it is finished. Anytime you got a hold of that and begin to magnify what God has already finished for you, then you will begin to see the manifestation of it. But you're not catching on to that. Genesis 15. Say, Abraham believed God. Now I'm not preaching something that say, go on sinning. That's not what I'm saying. You must just dash with all your church rules and regulations and just understand, say, you're under grace and continue with your same old lifestyle. That's not what I'm saying, because if you are to be saved by grace and really appropriating grace, then you're not going to live a sinful life. You need to understand that, because the Bible says where sin abound, grace abound much more. So, and the Bible tells us that sin shall not have dominion over you because you're not under the law, but you're under grace. So when you begin to rule and grace begin to manifest in your life, it's not sin that will be coming out of your life. It will be the empowerment of grace that you are now manifesting. So I don't teach these things to give people license to sin, because you were sinning long before. But I want to give people a heads up, a knowledge, an understanding of what Jesus Christ did for them. Because the world don't know what Jesus did, because religious preaching and doctrine is what we hear every day. Every day we sit down and wait for the world to end. Because that's what religion tells. We say the world is going to end and God is going to come back. But what is the truth behind that? The Bible said, when you hear of famine and desolation and rumors of war and all of these things, Jesus was the one speaking here. He said, when I hear of these things, he said, don't be alarmed. because these things are just the beginning of sorrows. But he said, he go down further in the verse and he said, listen to me now. Hear what got happen. You see, this gospel what me a talk about, until this gospel of the kingdom is being preached for a witness to all nations, all tongues, all language, the end shall not be. You can't still kill up yourself. If you're still in our rules and regulations and you still keep law and commandment and you're still over back in the Old Testament, it means to say, God, you have to preach the gospel to bring the end. Until this gospel of the kingdom is being preached as a witness in the earth, the end shall not come. So the end are weird pound with to preach the gospel, the truth of Jesus Christ. The end now come until you do something. That is the prophecy of Jesus. So we sit down and wait for the end to come, and the end are weird pound with to preach the real gospel. Because you see, all that you are hearing about now in the world is controversy, is bad news. And the Bible tells us that the gospel of the kingdom is good news. So when bad news are happening all over the world and good news come, good news must counteract the bad news. It is the good news now that is going to put an end to the bad news. Hallelujah. But the end cannot come if you are still locked up in religious doctrines. The end cannot come as a fact if you don't preach this gospel of the kingdom. What is the gospel of the kingdom? The grace of Jesus Christ. The grace that God sent down to man. His love, his mercy, his goodness. You see, the kingdom is enticing, you know, but religious people make you look dead. Religious people make you look like no life, no night. And, you know, attractive to people on the outside. But I'm here to tell somebody this morning that the kingdom is very attractive. The kingdom have everything in it what you need. But you need to come in. You need to come in. I'm saying this morning, works won't get it done because Jesus is the one who finish the job. Let's look at Romans 4 and verse 4, what he says there. Verse 4 says, now to him that worketh is the reward not a reckon of grace, but of debt. You see, if you work for something, you expect something owing to you. You're expecting a reward. You're expecting a pay. So that is why we treat God so. That is why we work. We do a service them and say, these things we have to do to get God to bless we. These things we have to do to get the sacrifice of Jesus for appropriate it up our life. Yeah, that's how you go. And that's how you go. The Bible tells us about the gift of righteousness. So if righteousness is a gift, oh, you go work for it. You can't work for something. You cannot work for a gift. A gift is given freely without merit. It is the unmerited favor of God coming to you. And so in order to receive it, you must believe it for what it is. And to tell that you don't believe it and you're not receiving it, you're still working. You're still there busy with all of your works. Saying, say, this me have to do for God bless me because me not receive what Jesus do for me yet. So there is an obligation when you work. It's like God is obligated to you. Right? Because you have not accepted his free gift. Let's look at verse 5. Verse 5 says, but to him that worketh not, but believe on him that justifieth the ungodly, his faith is counted for righteousness. So it is credited to us when we believe on Jesus. You see, as long as you come to receive what Jesus did for you and believe, say, look here, at Jesus Christ, I'm going to make me right now before God's side because Jesus Christ take upon him body my punishment. And because he take upon him body my punishment, I can now be accepted by the Father. So now care the issue where you have in your life and not care the circumstances where you're going around you. If you just believe on the Lord Jesus Christ in what he did for you, there will be a credit to your account of righteousness. It's like your digital phone. When you want credit, you go in and you top up and you get your credit. But this credit of righteousness that Jesus Christ brings to us is a lifetime credit. You can't talk it off. You can't sin it off. Hallelujah. And some people hear me say that, they can't accept that. Because a sin make you go to hell. If you sin, you go to hell. How is that possible? And a sin make you go to hell, you know? Right now, under this new covenant, and a sin make you go to hell. And the rejection of Jesus Christ make you go to hell. Because look here. God understands that we're not perfect. And so the more we work, and the more imperfect we present ourselves. But the more we lean on the righteousness of Jesus Christ and understand, say, I feel righteousness make we righteous, then we now go make the grade. Because grace can only empower our life when we receive what Jesus did for us. When grace empower your life, it free you from addiction, sexual immoralities. It free you from being drunk, coke out, all of them something. All of them something, Christ have the power to change them, you know. And you know, if you go on a rehab. Me said, in a God, in a grace, everything where mankind suffer from is in the method of grace. But if you don't receive what Christ did for you, for that situation, it won't change. So that is why I say salvation attractive. The kingdom attractive. Because life can be changed. People can be made right. People can come out of their lifestyle where they're addicted to the pornography, the sex, the homosexuality. And all of these things that people become addicted to because of sin. I'm saying to you this morning, you can be made free. Why not take works? It takes the grace of God to liberate you. But how do you appropriate this grace of God in your life? It's only when you believe that Jesus was the one who came to free you. There are many people that can testify this morning that they were born homosexual and they came out of it. There were many people that can testify this morning that they might take coke from their smile, and when Jesus touched their life, then come out. Come on, the grace of God is sufficient. It is attractive. It carry weight. It carry power to free you. The sin where you sin can't outflow the grace of God. And so sin not really send nobody a hell. What will send you to hell is when you reject what Christ put in place for you. Hallelujah. If God made this salvation come to all man and you choose not to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and appropriate his grace and his blessing in your life, if you got hell and a theme fat and you reject what come to free you from that punishment there. And so we need to understand this morning who we are and what God has done for us. Hallelujah. He has done it. I'm telling you. The thirst where you are thirsty still, you can't stop thirst. Some woman say, me can't keep one man. Me don't know if me come in a church or me I go do it. Some man say, me can't keep one woman. Me don't know if, look here, I'm saying to you this morning, because this grace has been made up available, you can do it. You can do all things through Christ who strengthened you. What a wonderful Savior. You mean say the grace of God can make me keep one woman? Yes. The grace of God can make you stop from prostitution? Yes. It can satisfy you. It makes you whole. It makes you never thirst again. Didn't you hear about the woman at the well? When she understand who Jesus was, she said, come see a man. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So me not go on like say me holy and dow. Because all that we have we fault, our weaknesses, and all of them something. Because mankind is make with weakness. But I'm telling you about the liberation power of God Almighty. That when you come down upon you and you ask God for liberator from something, you can be made free. When the enslavement of sin have you locked up and bandaged up in a homosexuality, you feel guilty about it. You know I say wrong, but my God, you can't help yourself. This morning, I'm saying to you, there is grace. Hallelujah. There is the grace of God coming to your life this morning from Styles FM studio is the gospel of the kingdom. And I'm saying to somebody that there is hope in God. You don't have to look at the works and exalt them. Say, there's something that me have to go do. Me have to go stop doing me. I do. Me can't stop myself, so me can't serve God now. Me can't serve God now, because you don't know you are Miss Miller. I judge me, push me, make a living. And if me come in a God, me no go have no living, because that no right. A lie, a lie. God can change your life, because he's that awesome God. Hallelujah. Didn't you look at Joseph's life, where Joseph was just a slave and Joseph went to prison. He came out of the pit. He was sold into slavery and God take him out of that and make him the prime minister. Me say, with God, all things are possible. But you don't believe. Your faith is in yourself and what you can do for yourself. And that is why man death is so nasty, because they don't believe in God. But I want to say to you this morning, do you believe that God loves you? Because you see, in order for you to put confidence in a smart, you have to know the person well. You have to understand the person. You have to have a relationship with the person. You not just get up and put all your trust in a smart where you don't know from where you are. But I'm saying to you, God loves you. And he wants to make your life over. He wants to fit the bits and the pieces that are broken up, that it seems like nobody can put back together. You are spilled out. Your gut is on the ground. But this morning, if you can hear my voice coming to you, I want to bring hope to somebody this morning. And I want to say to somebody that you don't have to die where you are. Hallelujah. You don't have to stay in that lifestyle and come to death. Come to a quick end. Hallelujah. Because the devil ravish your life. That's what he does in the human being life. The Bible says he come to kill, to steal, and to destroy. He destroy family and marriages. He break life and break heart. Yes, he uses whatever he can to pull people apart and to destroy. But here is Jesus Christ. He said, I am come that you might have life. Hallelujah. I am come that you might have life. Hallelujah. I am come that the things that you could not conquer, you may be able to conquer. I am come that if you are in prostitution and you can't get out, if you can just believe me and trust me and ask for my help, I can bring you out. If you're a thief and you want to stop thief and you can't stop thief, Jesus is come. Hallelujah. If you're a homosexual and you want to stop homosexual, but you don't know how to stop homosexual, Jesus come for all these things. He come to deal with all our hypocrisy. He come to deal with all our bondage. He come to deal with all our enslavement. The devil enslaved mankind way back down there in the Garden of Eden, where Adam gave up his reign to the devil, the wicked one. I'm not telling myself enough time, and that's why man do something and hide, because they know saying all right. They don't feel free doing it, and so they hide. Why you hide then? If you think say, well, I do all right, and you're okay with it. Your spirit, man, your mind. No, you don't agree, not agree with what you do, and so you hide. You know why you hide and why you have to hide and continue to do it? Because you're enslaved. But Jesus is here today to liberate you. Jesus is here today to do for you what you can't do for yourself. It doesn't matter the situation that you're enslaved under. Today, if you exalt Jesus, the God, the Son of God this morning, upon what he has done for you, if you cry out to him and ask for his help, I'm here to tell you this morning that without a shadow of a doubt, he will free you from whatever consequence you are under. Whatever you suffer from, he can bring hope to your life. So our righteousness is credited unto us, not by works, but by faith. It is when we put faith in Jesus Christ and his finished work that we are make the righteousness of God. Righteousness is not something where you do. Righteousness is something we credit to you. God see you as righteous when you believe Jesus Christ. I'm trying to show people how to obtain righteousness. Because over the years and the centuries and you name it, people have been trying to obtain their own righteousness through works. If you were to work hard to obtain this, it wouldn't be a gift. The Bible said the righteousness is the gift of God to mankind. It's a gift. So if it's something that you're going to work for, then it wouldn't be a gift. It would have been your righteousness, what you work for. Now, what I'm telling you is that you are ungodly and far from God, cut off from friendship. And Jesus was sent by God to take upon himself the punishment of man when they sin against him. We are back over there in the Garden of Eden. If you receive what Jesus did for you as your only way of salvation, then you will be made righteous this morning with your issue. Same place they wish by your day. If you just bow your head right now and say, Father, me no understand everything how you go and the walk to salvation and the journey, but me hear the woman on the radio I preach this morning, and Father God, me hear and it prick my conscience. There's something in me that wants this. And Father, right now, I surrender. Hallelujah. I surrender to your Lordship. I surrender to you, God, as my Savior, Jesus Christ. I believe in what you have done for me, and I receive your forgiveness for my sin. If you just simple say that from a true heart this morning, no circumstances where you have in your life can change you, can undo you. You are righteous. That is what Jesus says. That is what the word of God says about you. If you're even going to live in your man's house, and your man even have to go to bed, that no change your status. Because I know you are going to change your life and fix it and put the pieces together. It's gradually. As God, as you cry out and you begin to trust God, then he bring you out of your circumstances. That is why the church is so mixed up. Because then try to fix your life. If you got married to people enough, you're married to and bring damnation by yourself. Because they might try and make you work for your righteousness. But this morning, wherever you may be, right there in your prison cell, right there in your situation, right where you are upon the corner, puff your weed. Can you believe God today? Can you believe the word of God coming out to your life from Styles FM Radio? Can you believe the voice you are hearing? It is coming straight from the throne of heaven. A female voice you are here, but the inspiration, knowledge that is coming out to you, it's coming from heaven this morning. And God wants you free. He wants you liberated. Because that's why Jesus come. Jesus Christ no come from heaven. Butter upon the cross. Take the bruise. And I what we take in our body for we live a slothful life. For we live a defeated life. For we live locked up in a bondage still. For we still be humanizers and fornicators. That's not why he took punishment. In take it so you could have life, real life, classy life, where you can overcome everything you been under and bow to and say you're a Christian. You know why? Because you have not appropriate grace in your life. You're depending on your works. And as long as you hook up and work and say, yeah, work for something from God, then all you're going to do is continue to mess up. As long as you think that what you do, then you're not come to receive the grace yet. And it is only when you receive what Jesus Christ do for you, then you will see grace start to manifest from your life. And anytime grace manifests from your life, you are going to be triumphant. You will not bow to the wimps. You will not bow to Satan. You will not mess up same way and fornicate same way and live an adulterous life same way because you have appropriate God's grace in your life. So you will walk right and live right. So the church implicate all of the works and tell people say there's something they have to practice and do. And I wonder why people not change because no grace not in what we are doing. Because them believe so they change now all the things them what them are practice. And then do the something them from the outward and say that this I'm a change. And that's not the real change. Because real change comes from within you. You have to have a changed mind in order to see changed deeds. Listen to me this morning and receive God for who he is. Because he wants to make you free. Now I told you last week what righteousness mean in the kingdom of God. Because some people hear about righteousness and the first thing that come to their mind, they have to go do everything right with their own strength. And I don't know what I mean. You know, get it. That is why when Jesus Christ say, you know, seek ye first the kingdom of God and quickly add to it and his righteousness. Because he understands that mankind have a set agenda of righteousness. They have one standard of righteousness where they know from the old covenant. But he says, seek my way of righteousness. Seek my way. Seek the kingdom's way of righteousness. How can you be made right in the kingdom? What will qualify you for the benefit of the kingdom? It's Jesus. Hallelujah. It's only when you are dear, when you apply to the blood of Jesus for your salvation, that's when we are qualified. I know for your works. Some people say, we say, but me have to work to get the blood to qualify me. I know so you go. You get the blood to qualify you first and then you are qualified for service. So you have to first be qualified before you can serve. That's how we go. But some people think of the other way around. They have to serve for their qualification. And that's not it. That's not it. So righteousness mean it is that rightly aligned relationship with a governing authority to qualify for the rights to receive governmental privilege. So these privileges know that we are qualified for. It is the joy, the peace. Eh? We are qualified now for acceptance in the kingdom. We are qualified now for identity. We have an identity in the kingdom. We are qualified now for security. All our life is provided for. All of these kingdom rights now become yours. When God sees you as righteous, and you are only made righteous when you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and what he did for you. So this is the kingdom standard of righteousness. I know what you think of what you have to do. Because that was in the old. You see, that is it. So many people say they receive Jesus Christ as their Lord and they still have practiced the principle of the old covenant. And that age is abolished. That age has come to an end because the fulfillment of what was the picture over there is now here. So you don't have to do those things anymore and say, this me I do, forget God for do. And that's not how it is anymore. You believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. And at this covenant and at this dispensation, you believe God. It is by faith in Jesus Christ that you are made righteous. So our righteousness, it means to align yourself or to come into a relationship with a governing authority to qualify for the right to receive governmental privileges. How do one tell when they receive what Jesus did? How can you tell when you receive? How can you tell that you believe what Jesus did for you? It is our corresponding action
of that which we believe will tell if we believe. It is what we do when we say we believe. Because you can tell me, say, we believe that Jesus Christ died for me sin, yes? But guess what? You have a party. Because church boring. You don't believe. You don't understand it neither. Because you have to understand to say church not really boring. As a religion make church look boring. Because then tell you, say, you can't do this, and you can't wear that, and you can't do your hair, you can't wear makeup. And you can't do one whole heap of stuff. That's bondage. That's work. That's effort on your part. Why you can't do these things? Because you have to work for your salvation. So church not really boring. And these things are not really taken away from you. In fact, these things, when you look at makeup and the falls, you're all like something that to me are the manifested grace of God in the earth. Because me, I tell you, makeup makes some people look really pretty. Because that sin come in a people's life and make people look ugly. But when the grace of God begin to manifest through the skilled artists of makeup and the people who make the ear, Lord God, when they're done with you, see God will shine from your life. Come on. The things that they tell you not to do, these are only religious bondages. Is there any fact to it? Is that what the word really says about you? Is that what you need to do to say that you're righteous? To dress a particular way, to not do some stuff, to not wear some stuff, to not eat some food, to not worship to uncertainty. Come on! Is that really it? Because if that are it, any man could have made themselves righteous. Jesus Christ would need to come here to the earth and suffer so. If that was it, because me could have do it. It just take confirmation. You just have to confirm. Just confirmation. You just confirm to a bunch of rules and change the outward. But art still not change. You still have hurt and pain where people malice you and ill-treat you and do you bad. And you still suffer from bad art. And you still want to kill some people. Because guess what? That not change the art. It takes the flow of grace to bring change and peace and healing to man. Heart. It takes the flow of God, grace. And so we exclude grace out of the pitch down. We exalt, we work them. As if it is in what we do. This message is not finished. But I'll stop here for today. And as I stop here for today, we will take up on it again Sunday. So make sure you stay locked to Styles FM. Make sure you know. Come off of the dial for an inch. Because guess what? This message will be continuing. So until next Sunday, I want to wish you God's richest blessing upon your life. This is how I want to say goodbye for today. And the Lord bless and keep and make his face to shine upon you for a prosperous 2015.
close to you.
Let's give God this worship. If you know he's awesome, come on, stand on your feet, everybody. If you know he's awesome, you're in awe of his grace. You're in awe of his goodness. You're in awe of his mercy. You're in awe of his provision. He's great and he's greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. Come on, everybody, lift your hands as we lift our voices.